Welcome to our YouTube Live, and we are also feeding this into Facebook. So greetings here. Hey, sorry I missed Tuesday, my normal day. Taking a couple weeks vacation, went golfing with my son in Bend, Oregon. Had a good time on that day. But we are here today, and this is going to be a good one. This is going to be a good one. My forward movement causes red seas to part. My forward movement causes red seas to part. We're going to talk today about the importance of believing we're moving forward and having a strategy to move forward. And can't wait to get into it. Good morning, Judy. Love you. And yes, red seas are parting right now for folks today. I like that. Hey, before we get into the content here, I wanted to just share that starting on Monday, we are doing Limitless Kids. Limitless Kids, and it's a two-week online event for children using my books. You're crazy if you don't talk to yourself. I love that one. But let's just laugh at that for kids, part one and two. And that's happening starting on Monday. If you want to find out more information on Limitless Kids two-week online event, you can go to ignitinghopeacademy.com. And starting first week of August, I'll be doing my eight-week fully convinced course. It's going to be, I am just so thrilled about that. I've been just preparing for it, writing, just the Lord wants us to live a life of being fully convinced about who we are, excuse me, what we're doing, attaching great faith to who we are and what we're doing. And then also the book is going to be talking about the art of decision making, talking about how to make powerful decisions, because how we make decisions is more important than the decisions that we make ourselves. Patricia, welcome, Portland, Oregon. Lauren, good to have you here from Taiwan. Terry, yes, Tamara. Now, in my book, Higher Perspectives, and I've written a number of devotional books, and these devotional books are, I mean, some of them got Victorious Mindsets, Higher Perspectives, Igniting Hope in 40 Days, Igniting Faith in 40 Days, Possessing Joy, and others, Cracks in the Foundation. They're all devotional books, and I love just having books where people can just pick it up, open to a page, and just get their hope ignited, get their beliefs upgraded, get their joy strengthened. And this is one of them, Higher Perspectives. And I take in this, I take 50 situations in the Bible, either people who had a higher perspective than those around them. By the way, Romans 12:2 says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So we get transformed by not trying harder. We get transformed by believing something higher than what we're feeling and experiencing. And this higher perspective has that. And I'm going to be talking today about higher perspective number 25 in the book, Higher Perspectives, and it's forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things that are ahead. By the way, let me just give you some of the other higher perspectives in the book. All things are possible to him who believes. Number two is, if only I may touch him. Three is bringing every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. Four, this day the Lord will deliver you into my hand. That's what David said. That's a higher perspective. And He knelt down on his knees three times a day and prayed. Daniel did that, and just on and on. Or David said, I'm going to become even more undignified than this. I'm going to become more undignified. That's a higher perspective. But this one, and we're talking today about my forward movement causes Red Seas to part. This one, number 25, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward. Now, let me read to you Philippians 3, 12 through 14. It says, I press on. Why don't you just say out loud, I press on. I press on. Man, that's a powerful declaration. I press on. I press on that I may lay hold of that for which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me. There's a purpose why that the Lord Jesus has laid hold of you. Paul says, I press on to lay hold of that which Christ Jesus has also laid hold of me. Brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended. I love what he says. He says, Paul says, I don't count myself as having reached perfection, of having reached the highest potential. He says, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things that are ahead. And then he says, I press. Just say, I press. By the way, it's like a bench press. It's like, I press. We only get muscle by pressing against resistance. And we get muscle, you know, physical muscle is nice, but belief muscles is more powerful. And just as in the natural, we get stronger muscles by pushing against resistance and lifting weights and things like that. It's the same way in our belief muscles. We press against resistance. We press against emotions that are or negative mindsets that we feel, whether it's hopelessness, whether it's victim mindset, whether it's pessimism, whether it's feeling like a failure. And all of that is we press against those with the truths of God, with the beliefs of God, with declarations, and we build new strongholds in our lives. So Paul said, I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. And certainly there's an upward calling, you know, that our heavenly home, that is the upward call. But I believe there's upward calls that we have in our lives right now. Faithfulness. If we're faithful at the level we're at, we will get increase. We will get more. We will get more influence, more resources. It's impossible to be faithful at the level you are at and not see a greater effect of that. And by the way, faithfulness is not just showing up. It's how we think when we show up. Yep, Tom, that's why your muscles are so huge. You got, like all of us, some resistance to push against, some resistance in situations that are in our lives that, you know, I love just the story of Ezekiel 37, where God shows Ezekiel a valley of very dry bones. And because God's not afraid of us seeing how dry things are, just as long as we don't get our beliefs out of its dryness. God's not afraid of us seeing how dry things are, just as long as we don't get our beliefs out of its dryness. And so we have all these dry things pushing against us. We have dry family situations. We have dry financial situations. We have dry habit situations within our lives that we see and we don't deny them. We don't deny that there's issues and concerns, but we don't get our beliefs out of what we see or feel. And so, but in Philippians 3, 12. Ariel, great to see you on here. Bless you, Lynn, Janet, Melissa. And so we see in Philippians 3:13, Paul says, but one thing I do. If Paul says, hey, there's one thing I do, and he's talking about pressing on, he's talking about apprehending that which was why he was apprehended. And he says, one thing I do, he says, forgetting those things that are behind and reaching forward to those things that are ahead. Reaching forward to those things. Just say those things. Not one thing, those things. We're not limited by in our lives. We don't just have one avenue or one direction or one thing that we can do. We have those things. Now, he said, one thing I do, forgetting those things that are behind. You know, if we don't have a vision for our future, if we don't have hope, and hope is the belief that the future will be better than the present, and I have the power to help make it so, hope is the belief that the future will be better than the present, and I have the power to help make it so. If we don't have hope, if we don't believe there's a good future, if we don't believe we can make a difference, if we don't believe there's those things ahead for us in our lives, then we will be looking backwards. Our focus will not be forward, it will be backwards. And again, you know, you look at a car and the windshield is really big, the rear view mirror is really small. The windshield is really big, the rear view mirror is really small. That should let us know where our gaze is to be mostly. Our gaze is to be forward. Our gaze is to pull out of the future. This week's podcast that I am doing, and which will be released today or tomorrow from Igniting Hope Ministries, is about Viktor Frankl and hope and what he teaches on hope. And he was a therapist who was a Jew in Austria, and he went to the concentration camps in Germany, the Nazis, and he survived the concentration camp and wrote a book and talks about just his experience and talked about people who survived the concentration camps who didn't. And he said the one ingredient that caused people to survive was having hope for the future, having something to live for, having a purpose that they believe was going to happen and that they believe they were being prepared for. And even the negative things that were happening in their lives was leading into that. And so if we don't have a focus for the future, then again, we'll be looking backwards. We'll be living in regret. We'll be living in, oh, I wish the good old days would return. We'll be fixating. We'll be fixating on if onlys. If only I would have done that. If only I wouldn't have done that. And on our focus, it is not forward, it is backwards. And so Paul said, one thing I do, forgetting those things that are behind. And he had a lot to forget. Certainly, we want to remember a lot of things. We want to remember the testimonies. We want to remember the blessings. We want to remember how God came through. We want to remember those points. But Paul, yeah, he was, before he was converted, he was responsible for the deaths of many, many Christians. And he could have lived in regret. He could have lived in guilt. He could have lived in if onlys for the rest of his life. But somehow he did what he needed to do about those situations. And then he said, I'm going to move forward. I'm going to forget those things and I'm going to reach I'm going to reach to those things that are ahead, reaching forward. Now, and so those things, again, it says, forgetting those things that are behind and reaching forward to those things that are ahead. And one of the most important things that we need to do, and I believe even on this YouTube live today, one of the most important things that we need to do that's being released over you, those watching live, those watching the recording, is that there's a grace being released to you right now to move forward in your life, to move forward. You know, you get a train, and a train, you can put a 2x4 board in front of a train, and it will stop it from being able to start. It will stop it from being able to start. But once you get a train moving, it can smash through a brick wall. It can smash through a brick wall. Now, in Exodus 14, 15, the children of Israel are, by the way, great to see Ali, love you, and Stefan so much there in Spain. One thing that in Exodus 14, 15, the children of Israel are in a very difficult situation. Difficult, to say the least. They have just escaped out of Egypt. Well, they escaped. God delivered them out of there. And Moses, their leader, they're leading, and they're headed towards the promised land. And they come up to the Red Sea. And they're stuck. Their forward movement is blocked. And the Egyptians now are chasing them from behind. So what happens here in their situation is their future, there doesn't seem to be a future. It's blocked. And then their past is catching up with them. And things from their past is going to overtake them and kill them. That could preach right there. That feeling like the things of our past are going to rob us of our future. By the way, the past in itself does not have the power to block our future, but the conclusions that we make because of our past is what can block us. The past doesn't have the power. Nobody's past, no matter how horrible it is, has the potential of stopping. God is a recalculating God. God's a recalculating God. You know, when I use my GPS system and I take a wrong turn, the GPS system doesn't say, "You just blew it. This trip is over. I cannot get you to where you need to go from here." Now, it just says recalculating. I can still get you there. And so nobody's past has the power to block their future, but current beliefs can, the conclusions that we make. And so you've got the Israelites there crying out to God, Red Sea, Egyptians chasing them, and they... And God says this to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell my people to move forward." Why are you crying out to me? Tell my people to move forward. Yeah, I'm sure that Moses and the children of Israel said, "Man, I thought that's what we're supposed to do. I thought that's what, hey, we're in a bad situation. I thought that's what we're to do. We're to cry out to you and have you do something." And certainly there's a truth in that. But I want to bring out another truth. Tell my people to move forward. By the way, I'm going to be the Moses in your life today. Move forward. You say, what do you mean move? I'm just trying to survive. Move forward. And, you know, there's a time to pray. There's a time to pray. Hey, Yancey, great that Grand Rapids, Michigan's in the house. There's a time to pray. And then there's a time not to pray and to move forward. Some people just are in a begging mode. And the Lord is just saying, yep, thank you very much. Now ask me what it means to move forward. Ask me what it means to move forward. And I'll tell you this. And they moved forward when it looked like it was pointless, when it looked like it wasn't going to make a difference. We're just moving forward at a body of water. And then Moses raises his staff, and the Red Sea parted. The Red Sea parted. One of the greatest questions we can ask is, Lord, what does it look like for me to move forward right now? What does it look like for me to move forward right now in my life? And for some of you, it could be as simple as cleaning out your car, straightening up that room. That's forward movement. That you say, well, will that make a difference? Will that cause a Red Sea to part? I believe so. I believe so, especially if you feel like that's what the Lord is highlighting. For others of you, it's to take a course. It's to go back to school. It's to connect with your family at a deeper level. It's to write 5 minutes a day. 5 minutes a day and have someone help you do it. Forward movement. In general, you can pray that prayer, or you can have a situation in your life. And we all have those situations. We all have those situations where we have something that's concerning, something that may look hopeless, or something, a desire that we want to realize, and it hasn't happened yet. And we take that area and we say, Lord, I ask you for wisdom. I ask you for wisdom for what it means to move forward in that area. And you know, it says, if we ask for wisdom, we'll get it. If we ask in faith, not doubting. So when we ask, we just say, woo, I can't wait. Man, I've asked the Lord about that. I can't wait to hear the wisdom you're going to give me. You're going to give me. And because what this thing does, what this question that I'm asking does, it puts us out of reactive mode into proactive mode. And we can't just be reactive. We have a grace on us to be proactive and intentional. Proactive and intentional. It causes us, because if all we're doing is responding to life, just doing the regular things that we do, then again, it is really a backwards-looking focus of just trying to not lose what we have, trying to make sure that we're maintaining at least what we have, rather than moving forward, rather than growing within our lives, growing in our lives. Now, so here, yeah, that's the question. Wow, what does it mean to move forward? You say, well, I don't. Steve, you don't understand. You don't understand what I have going on. You don't understand what's going on in my family. You don't understand the disappointment. Listen, the children of Israel were in an impossible situation. Impossible. Red Sea in front of them. Egyptians chasing them down. And God says, why are you crying out to me? Tell my people to move forward, to move forward. I remember as a young pastor, I was just in the early 80s when I was in the Assemblies of God, and I love the Assemblies of God denomination. By the way, Lord, just bless the Assemblies of God here in America and around the world. And I was doing online courses to become credentialed with the Assemblies. And I was reading a book on pastoring. And one of the things that stood out to me in reading that book, it said that the author said that he had never found a discouraged pastor who was reading books. I have never found a discouraged pastor who was reading books. And that thing just hit me. I said, wow, you know, why? Because even in the context of what I'm sharing today, that then you're moving forward. You're doing something to move forward that's not connected with just responding to life, reacting to what's going on. You're actually proactive. You're intentional. You're investing in your future. You're investing in your future. So what does it look like? Now, I would love, we have many people in the chat on our YouTube channel, our Facebook channel. In the last few minutes of this today, I would love for you to put in there, some of you already have, maybe you could repeat that so I could see it. What does it mean for you to move forward? What is being highlighted? Maybe you're already doing it and you just want to confirm it, that it's already happening and this is what I'm doing. I'm listening to audiobooks. I do that on a regular basis. That's one of the things that I do. I make 100 declarations a day minimum. That's part of my, 700 a week. That averages out to 100 a day. That's part of my moving forward. And I've got help if I don't do it. I pay my assistant $3 a week. Every week I don't do 700 declarations. And so this is a teaching that I believe is revolutionary. And there's always a reason. There's always a reason why. Melissa, you say pain often and not worrying how good or bad I think they look. Oh, that's a good one. Christine, yes, audiobooks. Tanya, audiobooks. You're listening to the Word when you wake up. Wow. You start your day with a renewed mind. I love it. Janet, you're downsizing. Wow, what a great thing, downsizing for a move into a new home and eating God's Word, which is your fresh bread for each day. And I love that. You know, just the different things that you feel like the Lord is saying, and it's going to be different for each of us. And I love make declarations, worship music, podcasts, and read books. Christine, listening to worship. Oh my, these are all good, especially when we believe these are the things we're to do and we attach faith to them. Tamara, renew your mind daily with the Word of God. Tanya, cut out sugar going to the gym. Yes! Tom, you walk daily while listening to me. Well, Tom, thank you. I hope I'm an encouragement to you. Yes, worship. Jenny, you added keep your love on. Kylo, Danny Silk. Wow, what a great thing. Adding what Danny Silk and his team is doing. Tanya, started your business. I'm moving forward. I'm doing something. I'm not waiting. I'm not passive. I'm not just crying out to God. I'm actually doing something that I believe that I'm supposed to do. And those things, now here's the thing. My forward movement causes red seas to part. It's one of my favorite declarations. My forward movement causes Red Seas to part. Yes. Tamara, listening to me, declarations. Joseph, buy a plane ticket to a new place. Open new territory. Wow. Lauren, upgrading your grandma's house. Draw something daily, not overthinking. 55 declarations. I love that. 55. Woo. Starting your business. Brandy, so good. Tanya, you put an offer on a house. Wow. Wow. And you say, thank you, Igniting Hope. Keeps your head straight. By the way, this podcast that's coming up this week, you're going to like this one. Talking about Viktor Frankl, about him being a prisoner in a concentration camp in Germany, and some of the things he learned, and he released over people when he got out, and one of the and what he observed in people who actually survived. And it's really important. It's connected, obviously, to hope. It's Adele, you're believing above and beyond your circumstances and engaging in worship. My, oh, my. This has been such a powerful, powerful time. My forward movement causes Red Seas to part. Paul said in Philippians 3:13, one thing I do, forgetting those things that are behind. Just get overcoming the regrets, the if-onlys, even the good old days. Forgetting those things that are behind and reaching forward to those things that are ahead. My, oh, my. There always seems to be a good reason why now's not a good time to move forward. Now, it doesn't have to be a big thing. We want momentum in our lives, and we celebrate progress, not perfection. Helene, great, painting your house and cleaning house so you can move. I mentioned in the beginning this book, Higher Perspectives, is one of my devotionals. And, you know, I've written many devotionals, and I know for a lot of people it's not only the podcast, it's having the devotionals laying around and just opening them up. I mean, most of my books, not all of them, but most of my books have a devotional format, Higher Perspectives, Victoria's Mindsets, Let's Just Laugh at That, Cracks in the Foundation, Igniting Hope in 40 Days, Igniting Faith in 40 Days. They are books that they're short, to the point, and boom, they will jolt us into forward movement, into forward movement. Momentum. Momentum. Brandy, it's true. We get momentum in our lives, and we're going for it. We're going for it. Wow, wow, wow. Nancy, you're taking a vacation for the first time in 20 years and spending more time with your family. Woo, that is good forward movement. Love it. Love it. And again, when we just attach faith. I believe I'm going to do this. I believe this is the forward step that I am to take. Janet, you say, could I read one of the devotionals? Hey, let me just talk about this one. I've already talked number 25 in Higher Perspectives, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things that are ahead. I have in this book lower perspectives. Paul could have concluded, instead of saying, one thing I do, forgetting those things that are behind and reaching forward. He said he could have had these lower perspectives. His past disqualified him from God's best in the future. He could have believed that the purpose of his memory was to focus on his mistakes, so they would not happen again. He could have concluded, there are no greater things in the future for someone like me. He could have concluded, vision for the future does not give power for the present. He could have concluded, continually trying to fix his past will bring lasting change in life. Bring lasting change in life. And then I have elevating truths in this one, and I won't read them in detail, but the elevating truths of how to access this is past happenings are not as big a problem as our current beliefs. Past happenings are not as big of a problem as our current beliefs. Elevating truth number two is we have permission to forget that which needs to be forgotten. And then elevating truth number three, focusing on the things ahead, will build a wall against negatively dwelling on the past. Focusing on things ahead will build a wall against negatively dwelling on the past. And then giving God something to work with. Three things. Ask God for a revelation of the depth of his forgiveness. Lord, we ask you for a revelation of the depths of your forgiveness. Secondly, get healing ministry for the hurts of the past so that your conclusions about your identity line up with God's word. And then lastly, frequently review the promises and prophecies that God has made real to you. And then there's declarations we have in this devotional at the end. Declaration number one, I have an unusual ability to overcome regret and shame. Won't you say that with me? I have an unusual ability to overcome regret and shame. Declaration number two, great things are ahead for me in my life. Great things are ahead for me in my life. Say that with me. Great things are ahead for me in my life. And then declaration number three is I think on purpose and have vision for the future. Say that with me. I think on purpose and have vision for the future. The book is called Higher Perspectives. It's one of the devotional books that I've written. And I'll say this, you know, I believe these devotional books are just, I read my own books. I read my own books because I need it. And you put these in the bathroom, you put them somewhere where you're going to bump into it, open it up. And I'll tell you this, it's hard to think lies feeding on this stuff. Wow. Thank you so much, everybody. What a great live audience we've had. I'll be back with you on Tuesday at 8:30 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time for another great, great message that I'm going to have. And just subscribe to this YouTube channel, Facebook. We have other times. Our newsletter will tell you the schedule for when we're going to be on as well. And just remember, too, those of you who jumped on after I started, that we're starting on Monday, 2 weeks of Limitless Kids, a 2-week online event for children using my books. Let's just laugh at that for kids, part one and part two. And also, we're starting up here in August, the first week of August, my 8-week course is starting called Fully Convinced, The Art of Decision Making. Rochelle, I'm glad you signed up for Fully Convinced. Man, as a belief trainer, you are going to love that course. Fully Convinced, The Art of Decision Making, attaching great faith to who we are and what we do. You can find out all of our courses on ignitinghopeacademy.com. ignitinghopeacademy.com. Blessings, everybody. Thank you again for those of you who are a regular part of our Igniting Hope family, and we welcome those of you who are new. This may be your first broadcast that you've watched. Yeah, just we're here to ignite hope. There's no hopeless circumstances. There's just people who do not have hope. And once people get true hope, circumstances cannot stay the same. Cannot stay the same. I believe after love, hope is the most powerful leadership influential quality that there is. And I'll say this, our hope level determines our influence level, and he who has the most hope has the most influence. Wow. Randy, thanks for joining us today from Red Bluff, California. We pray blessings over Red Bluff. Terry, thank you. Judy, thanks for being such a strength on here on the chat. Hey, God bless. Bye, everybody.